Residing in Lee Hall is the Invents Community, an interdisciplinary collection of science and engineering majors, which includes the engineering communities Galileo and Hypatia, as well as Curie and Da Vinci. Curie and Da Vinci, otherwise known as CureVinci, are the living learning communities that merge undergraduates of the physical and quantitative sciences with majors of biological and life sciences. First-year undergraduates join our student-driven program because the integrated community of majors that spans three colleges provides a supportive space where opportunity is fostered, mainly due to the academic and professional engagements of the FYE course in the fall and the challenge of the studio project assignment in the spring. The studio projects are designed to teach the students the importance of the journey of learning rather than the end product. We were told long ago that we would face challenges that we would find difficult, but conquering each predicament was the reason of the assignment. By focusing on problem solving, we were able to create our rocket by joining the skills of each member of our group.
For our rocket, we chose to use the elliptical fin. The shape of the elliptical fin allows for lift on the rocket by creating the symmetrical airfoil. This causes the fin to be tilted in the wind and half of the airflow over each side of the fin. The elliptical fin has the lowest induced drag. The fin shape allows the air force to be closer to the tube of the body. Since the elliptical fins are longer at the end of the tube, there is less lift on the tip, so there is less pressure, resulting in less drag. Because of these findings and the simulation results, we chose the elliptical fin design. This design has proven to work when our rocket went higher and farther than the other team's rocket.
In terms of designing the rocket itself, at first the O-rings were too large, so we had to spend a lot of time sanding them down. After that, our fins were too small prior to the launch, so not only a week before the launch, we had to reprint out new fins that were double the size of our original ones. This caused our paint job to look a bit shaky as we didn't paint the fins, just glued them onto the rocket since we didn't have enough time to worry about painting.
We ran into problems soldering the Arduino because two of the soldering contacts weren't on the top side of the soldering board. I asked the coordinator, Matt, for help, and we were able to figure out a new soldering configuration that made the Arduino work for our rocket.
For the coding portion of our project, we first had difficulty with downloading and installing libraries into Arduino Sketch. Then we had difficulty with writing to the SD card and keeping the SD file open for us to write to. And finally, we had trouble with our sensor and getting our sensor to calibrate, even on launch day.